You are now listening to the Live Fire Radio Show with Pastor Beto on 91.9 FM Fellowship Radio, number one show in the Rio Grande Valley. 102.3 FM Life Radio, number one show in Fort Smith, Arkansas, and number one Facebook Live show at noon. Stay tuned for God's Word by Pastor Beto. Súbele!
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Live Fire Radio Show here this morning. God bless you. Thank you so much for tuning in. Hey, listen, we got a great show for you. Stay tuned. We got a good word. Good word that's going to edify your soul. It's going to edify your mind. It's going to edify your spirit. So stay tuned here on the number one show here on the Midday Show. Here with Pastor Beto. We leave you here with some Tejano Christian music here on 102.3 Radio Vida, La Estación Diferente. Súbele.
Petición de una madre. We'll be right back.
You are now listening to the Live Fire Radio Show with Pastor Bethel on 91.9 FM Fellowship Radio, number one show in the Rio Grande Valley. 102.3 FM Life Radio, number one show in Fort Smith, Arkansas, and number one Facebook Live show at noon. Stay tuned for God's Word by Pastor Bethel. Súbele!
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Radio Vida, la estación de Brenda, 91.9 Radio Compañeros. Saludos para el Grupo Filadelfia que lo está mirando. A él, hermano Velázquez. God bless you. Hey, man, we got to have you back on the Live Fire Radio Show. I've been working very hard so that we can bring you top quality sound and video as well here on 91.9. Muchos saludos allá para todos los de la 91.9 Radio Compañerismo. Thank you so much. Allá para number one show in the Rio Grande Valley. Number one show there on 102.3 Radio Vida, la estación diferente. Saludito para Betty. Saludito para la hermana Martínez. Saludito para Isabel Martínez. Pastor Kawita from Kenya. Saludito para Pastor Fritz. Allá saludito para Illinois. Saludito para Jimmy Henderson. Jimmy Henderson tuning in this afternoon on the number one show in the Rio Grande Valley. Number one show all over the Metroplex. That's right. We are the number one. We are working hard to make the number one show, no solamente aquí en el DFW, but all over the world. Vamos a ver cómo se escucha real quick.
Tuning in this afternoon on the...
Man, it sounds good. Muchas gracias to all the beautiful people that you've been tuning in to the Live Fire Radio Show for a long time. Almost 3 years, by the way. The Live Fire Radio Show, it's been around 2 years, más o menos. Muchos saludos allá para la 102.3 Radio Vida. You guys been very faithful to us, to the Live Fire Radio Show. And of course, 91.9 Radio Compañerismo. We've been kind of off the air for a little bit just because I've been working out behind the scenes to try to bring to you quality programming. We've now invested also in the church as well. I mean, this is a studio in my house that I have brought a studio inside my house. But now this same programming is going to hopefully be pushed out into the church so that we can get the word of God out there to you. Amen. So you can get quality online viewing so that you can get the word of God there in your houses. Pero muchos saludos para toda la gente que lo está escuchando. And listen, I got a word here for you. We were talking about the other day at church on Sunday, and we were talking about who told you to stop running. And not only is that a good question that we ask you, who told you to stop running, but also this is one thing that we gotta ask ourselves: not only who told you to stop running, but who are you running from? Now, when we run as Christians, we want to be running towards God. We want to be running towards the light. We want to be running towards the truth. We want to be running towards the life. We want to be running in the way, in the narrow way, which is difficult at times, but those who find it find eternal life. So I want to ask you this question because Paul, vamos a ver, el hermano Padilla los está tuning in this afternoon. Salito para el brother Jose Padilla. Hey, brother, God bless you, man. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good.
Good, man. I'm on the radio, but I can never turn down a phone call from Josue Padilla.
I really appreciate it. How are you guys doing?
Well, we're doing good, man. We're working aquí trabajando duro.
Qué bueno. Hey, listen, I wanted to ask you if there's a possibility that I could talk to you at some time today.
Yes.
That you could call me back about a possibility of some ministry for some families.
Absolutely. Let me call you right after the show, 2 o'clock.
All right. Am I on the air right now?
Yes, sir. Saluda a la gente.
I just wanted to say to everybody, God bless you. I hope everybody's doing fine, that everybody's, you know, just being blessed. I know that God is putting a hedge of covering around all of us with all this stuff that's going on around in the world, and it's good to know that we have a God that we can trust. So keep the faith. Don't give up, and God will do amazing things throughout this time.
Amen. That's Pastor Padilla. God, man. Bless. God bless you, man. Amazing, God amazing bless, man. Family. Thank you very much. Dios lo bendiga a todos. God bless you, sir. Hey, man, you can never turn down a phone call from a pastor, man. So that's a lesson learned. If a pastor ever calls you, just pick up the phone, man. You're going to be blessed. But, you know, I preached on Sunday, and I want to get comfortable here because I know we got a good word for you here today, here on the Live Fire Radio Show. And talking about Paul goes to Galatia. He's actually in Corinthians. He's preaching to the Corinthians. And then Galatia, he establishes a church in Galatia, which is the book of Galatians. And of course, he's speaking to the Jews because now the Jews are preaching this message where they're preaching circumcision. And now Paul's at this time where he's literally telling them, hey, who told you to stop running? Like who got in your way of this running that you were running so nobly? And you were running very nobly, but now somebody has interfered in your walk. Somebody has interfered in your running towards the light, towards the life, towards the truth. And somebody's been hindering you, and somebody's stopping you from heeding, from paying attention, from understanding and following the truth. Following the truth, you know, you got to deny yourself. You got to pick up your cross daily so that you may follow Christ. And Paul comes to a conclusion that somebody has hindered heresy, false teaching, religion has hindered the Galatians from following Christ Jesus. So we come to this point, and I want to go to the book of Proverbs here this morning on 102.3 Radio Vida, La Estación Diferente. You're also listening to us on 91.9. Radio Compañerismo, number one show. Saludos allá para el Grupo Filadelfia. Man, I love Grupo Filadelfia, man. I mean, you just turn on Grupo Filadelfia and you're worshiping immediately, man. Allá con los acordeones y los sextos. God bless you guys. I know you're going to be here in the DFW real soon. And if you are, we're going to have you on the show. Not only on the show, but we want to have you here at church. Yeah, New Life Church. But the Bible says this. Jimmy Henderson, this is, stay blessed up, brothers and sisters. I'm about to go on the air here in Kennedy, Texas. 990 AM, 95.3 FM. I'm DJing here. So, send me Jimmy. It's amazing. Isn't that amazing? How God just uses people that are willing to be used by God. And if that's one of you there, that you have a vision, you have a dream, hey, man, nobody's going to work as hard in your dream as you are. You got to stay consistent. You got to stay committed. And you got to hold on to that faith. Hold on to that promise. But the Bible says this, that the wicked flee when no one is pursuing, when no one pursues. When no one pursues, the wicked flees. But the righteous are bold as a lion. Amen. These are the times, and the times that we're living in right now, where it's very crucial that we are not hindered by the voice of the enemy, that we're not hindered by the lies of the enemy. This is the time when we, the righteous, are bold as a lion. Saludito para mi hermana querida, Miss Ruth. God bless you. I love you. Next time I see you, I'm going to give you such a big hug. Amen. Que no te voy a soltar. Ya no te voy a soltar. Amen. We got a lot of work to do. Allá para toda la familia Martínez y Ochoa. God bless you. Mutales Josh. God bless you, brother Beto Mesa, and watching from Uganda. God bless you. Allá para toda la gente bonita de Uganda. We love you. This is the time where we cannot flee when nobody is chasing us. We cannot flee when nobody is pursuing us. Only the wicked flee. This is not the time for us to flee from confronting what is trying to confront this nation, what is trying to confront the church. Paul was very clear. Who stopped you from running this race that you were running so nobly? Who interfered and hindered you and stopped you from following the truth? You know, in this time of quarantine, of social distancing, a lot of us have overdone it, have seriously overdone it. Now, definitely we got to take our precautions at church. Everything is sanitized, everything is clean, but my Lord, the church, the body of Christ, it is the place where if you are sick, you call on the elders to come and lay hands on you. The church is the place where the prayers of the righteous avail much. The church is the place where you can come to the altar, where you can come boldly, amen, into the throne of grace, and that is Christ Jesus. But the wicked, they flee. They flee when no one is pursuing you. Listen, this virus is not pursuing you. This virus is not catching up to you. This virus is not going to get you sick. We have the victory over the virus. By the blood of Jesus, by the stripes that Christ received, you and I have been healed in the name of Jesus. And the righteous, you and I, those who are covered by the blood of Jesus, the Bible says that we are as bold as a lion. You and I, at this moment, you and I have become as bold as a lion. Not like a lion. Only the devil roars like a lion. You and I, we roar as a lion. Because greater is he who is in us than he who is in the world. Amen. So now is the time, church, to regather. Now is the time, church, to come together. Now is the time, church, to come together and come into an agreement. One spirit, one God, one baptism, and that is the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says this in the book of Proverbs, chapter 18, verse 1, because remember, we're talking about who hindered you from running this race as nobly as you were running, as boldly as you were running. There are some of you that have stopped running this race. There are some of you that are fleeing and nobody is pursuing you. There are some of you on Proverbs 18 verse 1 that says, he who willfully separates and strangles himself from God. I'm talking to those people that at this moment you have found yourself to be estranged from God. You have found yourself to be separated from God. You have been separated from the church. You have been separated from your brothers, from your sisters. And you are seeking your own desire. That's what the Bible says. Proverbs 18 verse 1. You were running this race nobly. But something, fear interfered. A lie interfered. False preaching interfered. Something hindered you and stopped you from heeding, from paying attention, from understanding, from following the truth. And now you find yourself fleeing when nobody is pursuing. You are fleeing the presence of God. You are fleeing our Lord. You are fleeing your brothers and your sisters when nobody is pursuing you. Proverbs 18 verse 1 says this, he who willfully separates and estranges himself. In other words, you become a stranger to God. You become a stranger to your brothers and your sisters. You become a stranger to your pastor. You become a stranger to your church. Seeks his own desire. What a question that we got to ask ourselves here this morning. Am I seeking my own desires? Or can I honestly say, am I seeking God's desire? Now, how can we find that out? If we are seeking God's desires, or are we seeking our own desires? Well, very simple. The Bible is very clear. The Bible is very clear that God's desires, and let me look up that verse because God just gave me this verse right now. The desires of God is for man to know the truth. Now, if you find yourself in isolation, if you find yourself no longer running this race as nobly as you were running before, if you find yourself fleeing something that's not even pursuing you, if you find yourself willfully separating yourself, estranging yourself from God, estranging yourself from your brothers and your sisters, then it could be very clear that you are seeking your own desire. Well, you may say, well, Pastor, I'm seeking God's desires. Well, let's find out what God's desires are. And you're listening to 102.3 Radio Vida, La Estación Diferente, 91.9 Radio Compañerismo. Because if you find yourself that at one time you were running this race, you were running after God, you were running to pursue this prize, this victorious prize that God has already achieved for us, and at one point you were running this race nobly, but someone, something, some word, some emotion interfered. Something has hindered you. Something has stopped you from heeding, from following Christ Jesus, from following the truth, like Galatians chapter 5, verse 7 says. If you find yourself fleeing when nothing is pursuing you, you may say, you may be fleeing the sickness that's not even pursuing you. You may be fleeing the enemy that's not even pursuing you. And now you find yourself willfully separating, estranging yourself from God, estranging yourself from the church, estranging yourself from your pastor, from your leaders, from your brothers and your sisters at the church. But your excuse is that you are seeking God's desires. Well, you may find yourself at this moment seeking your own desires. Because the Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 4. The Bible says this. Now, you know what? Let's go to verse 3. And I don't got my glasses, so I'm going by faith. For this is good and acceptable in the sight of God, our Savior. Now, you ask yourself, this is good and this is acceptable. If you find yourself in a situation, in a place where you're telling yourself, this is good and acceptable, Pastor, what I'm doing right now, I'm separating myself from everybody. Okay, let's find out if you are doing, if you are fulfilling your desires or God's desires. Because whatever is good and acceptable in the sight of God, our Savior, who desires, this is his desires. If you're separating yourself from church, you're separating yourself from your brothers and your sisters, you're separating yourself from your pastor, from your ministers, from your leaders, and you do not desire that all men be saved and all men to come to the knowledge of the truth, then you are fulfilling your own desires. And this is what Proverbs 18 verse 1 says. He who willfully separates and estranges himself from God and man seeks his own desires and pretexts to break out against all wise and sound judgment. In other words, sound examination. Listen, a true friend, a true brother in the Lord, a true pastor, somebody who truly loves you, knowing that God is coming for a spot-free, no-spot church, if he sees you with a wrinkle on your garment, if he sees you with a spot, he will stop you in your tracks and say, brother, you have a spot on you. Brother, you have a wrinkle on you. Brother, let's iron that wrinkle. Brother, let's remove that spot. If you're seeking your own desires, you will find offense to that. But if you're willing to take correction, you will say, Pastor, correct me. Brother, correct me. Sister, correct me. Why? Because I want to be found in the garments of Christ. I want to be found with no wrinkle. I want to be found with no spot. And the Bible says a self-confident fool. You know what a fool is? A fool is somebody who does not believe in God. That's what a fool is. You know, I tell these youngsters, stop calling each other, stop calling yourselves fools. I hear these youngsters all the time. Hey, what's up, fool? Stop calling yourself fools. Fools is somebody who does not believe in God. A self-confident fool is even worse. You have confidence in your own self that you're going to be saved? Now that's a real fool. Someone who doesn't believe in God. A self-confident fool has no delight. Listen to me. Has no delight in understanding. The Bible says that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. That is the way. That is salvation. Cometh to the knowledge of the Holy One. That is truth. That is a relationship. Bringeth understanding. That is life. That is life, and that is eternal life, and that is found in Christ Jesus. The understanding, the revelation, where the scales come off, and you're able to understand what this amazing book is talking about. But a self-confident fool has no delight in understanding, has no delight in the afterlife, has no delight in the everlasting life with Christ Jesus. The self-confident fool has no delight in the understanding, but only in revealing his personal opinions and himself. Wow. Maybe you can ask yourself this question. Have I been separating myself way too long from God? Have I estranged myself from God? Have I estranged myself from the church? Have I estranged myself from my brothers and my sisters? It's okay to separate yourself, but to come into the presence of God, to choose the good part, to choose to be at the feet of Jesus, that is a good part. That is the part where you want to separate. Jesus separated himself all the time to be in the presence of the Father so that he can hear that voice, so that he can be full of love, so that he can be full of power, so that he can be full of a sound mind. But if you're separating yourself, you've been separating yourself, you've been estranging yourself from God, from the body of Christ, you got to stop now. You got to stop today. If you are fleeing something that's not even following you, the Bible says that the wicked flee when no one pursues. Amen. But the righteous are bold as a lion. This is the time, this is the season where the church awakens and we become as bold as a lion. We know the truth. We know the way. We know the truth. We know the life. We only have eyes towards the way, the truth, and the life. We don't turn to the left. We don't turn to the right. We can come boldly to the throne of grace to receive mercy and grace in the day of trouble. That is to be as bold as a lion, roaring as a lion. But a self-confident fool, you've been estranging yourself from God, from the church, from the truth, has no delight in understanding, has no delight in life, but only in revealing his personal opinions. Listen, there's nothing wrong with having an opinion. But at some point, that opinion has to have a foundation. Or else you'll be like that foolish man that dug and built his foundation of the house on quicksand or sand. And when the storms beat it, it shook it. It destroyed it. It took it. And the Bible says that this fool only reveals his personal opinions and himself. And when the wicked comes, listen to me. And when the wicked comes, because there is wickedness in this world. And when the wicked comes into the depth of evil, he becomes a contemptuous despiser of all that is pure and good. Listen to me. Please listen to my heart. I've seen it. As a matter of fact, I've seen it where people have estranged themselves from God. They've estranged themselves from the body of Christ. They've estranged themselves from your brothers and your sisters. It's like, we didn't do nothing to you. We're embracing you. Come back home. Come back to your family. Come back to your church. Go back to your family. Go back to your brothers. Go back to your sisters. Because the wicked comes and he becomes a contemptuous despiser. If you are despising the body of Christ, if you are despising what is good, what is pure, and with inner baseness comes outer shame and reproach. There's some people that are at home right now that are so ashamed of coming back to church because they think they're going to be judged. Because they think they're going to be reproached. Let me tell you something. You're not going to be reproached. Nobody's going to reproach you. You don't have to be ashamed. Get up. The Bible says that the righteous gets up seven. Fall is seven. But he gets up eight. Get up. Get up on your feet right now. Come back, church. Come back to God. Come back to your brothers. Come back to your sisters. Start running that race again that you were running so nobly at one point. That voice, those thoughts, take a hold of those thoughts. Take a hold of them. Bind those thoughts. Make them submit to the knowledge of God, which is Christ Jesus. Stop separating yourself from God. Stop separating yourself from your brothers and your sisters. Don't get into that point of no return. You've given sin an inch, but the devil has taken a mile. But you're still a child of God. There's a ring that the Father wants to put on you because you belong to Him. Get up. Get up from those swine that are around you. Get up from that mud and come back to the house of the Lord. Come back now. Your brothers, your sisters, we're waiting for you. Your pastor, he's waiting for you. He's been praying for you. He's been praying for your family. Come back now. The Bible says this. Do not cross that point of no return. Because you know what the Bible says? In the book of Hebrews, chapter 12, chapter 10, verse 26. Listen to my heart. Because I know you're there. I know you're out there. You may not be here right now, but you're going to hear this message later. And the Bible says in the book of Hebrews, chapter 10, verse 26, for if we go on deliberately, listen, you know the truth. You have felt the love. You have felt the embrace. He has taken you out of that pit of hell. He's healed you of your infirmities. He healed you of your drug addiction, of alcoholism. He healed you from that virus. He healed you from that disease. He restored your family. He restored your marriage. He restored your sanity. But now you go on deliberately and willingly sinning. Let's wake up. I know you're listening to me. Listen to me. Wake up. Stop deliberately and willingly sinning after once acquiring. Listen to me. After one, because I know you're not no fool. After once acquiring the knowledge of the truth. The knowledge of the truth. The relationship with Christ Jesus. There is no longer any sacrifice left. He is the way. He is the truth. He is the life. There is no other way. I know you're a good person. You say that. But the Bible says there is none of us that is good. None of us. Not even one. We've all fallen short of the glory of God. We're all sinners. Your goodness are filthy rags in the sight of God. The only righteous garments that you can wear are those covered by His blood that will make you holy. And if you continue to deliberately and willingly go on sinning, separating yourself, estranging yourself from God, estranging yourself from those that truly love you, those that pray for you, those that are discipling you, and you're seeking your own desire, your own fleshly desire, the own desires of your flesh, the own desires of the world, and your own desires, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the lust of the world. And you continually, deliberately, willingly sinning after once acquiring the truth of God. There is no longer any sacrifice left to atone over your sins. In other words, there is nothing, there is no one else that's going to pay for your sin. He's paid it all. He's done it all. There is no one else. There is nothing else. There is no other religion. There is nothing you can say. There is no crying out that you can cry out. There is nothing. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah, I don't care how much you cry out to him or how sad you look to him. Look at what the Bible says in the book of Isaiah, chapter 11. The Bible says in verse 3, his delight, Christ's delight, is in the fear of the Lord. This is why he was able to take on the shame and finish his purpose, finish his passion, carried the cross all the way to Calvary. Because his delight, his desire was to please the Father. And he shall not judge. Listen to me. He came as the Lamb. You continue to deliberately, willfully continue to sin after you have received the full knowledge of the truth. Christ will not judge by the sight of his eyes. What does that mean? That means that, well, I'm a good guy. I'm a good family man. I'm a good family person. I'm a good person. I'm an educated person. I pay my bills on time. He's not going to judge by what he sees. Pastor Beto can put on a nice pink shirt and a nice tie, and I look Christian. But Christ is not going to judge me by this silly tie and this color I'm wearing. He's going to judge me by the seal that is in me. Am I sealed for the day of redemption? And he's not going to judge by his eyes. The Bible says, Isaiah chapter 11, verse 3. Listen to me very carefully. Nor is he going to decide by the hearing of his ears. What does that mean? That he's not going to decide what the Bible says in Matthew 7:21. Not everyone that says to me, Lord, Lord. In other words, he's not going to decide whether you are saved. He's not going to decide whether you belong to him by what you say. Lord, Lord. He said, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but only he who does the will of my Father in heaven. If you go on deliberately, listen, and listen to my heart. Listen to my heart. If you go on deliberately and willfully sinning after once acquiring the knowledge of the truth, there is no longer any sacrifice to left to atone of our sins. No further offering to which to look forward to. There is nothing. The only thing coming is the rapture of the church. That's the next prophetic thing to come. Everything has been prophesied. Well, I mean, book of Revelation, the coming of Christ Jesus, establishes his kingdom on earth. We know all those things are coming. We know that. But right now, for the church, rapture. Pre-tribulation? Perhaps. Mid? Perhaps. Post? Perhaps. But be ready. And stop willfully and deliberately sinning. Because he's not going to judge with his eyes or with his ears. Are you sealed by the Holy Spirit for the day of redemption. That's why the Bible says, do not grieve the Holy Spirit, for he is your seal for the day of redemption. He's our seal. The Bible continues to say, there is nothing left for us then but a kind of awful and fearful prospect and expectation of divine judgment and examination. That's what judgment is. You know, next time you decide to tell somebody, well, you can't judge me. Well, I can examine you. My eyes see what my eyes see. My ears hear what my ears hear. And the Bible says that judgment will first come to the house of the Lord. That means that judgment, that means examination, will first come to us, the body of Christ. That's why we're raptured first. Because judgment comes, examination comes. Oh, seal, boom, raptured. These are mine. Boom. These are mine. That's what judgment comes to the house of the Lord means. And there's nothing else left but an awful and fearful prospect of expectation of divine judgment and the fury of burning of wrath and indignation, which will consume those who put themselves in opposition to God. You don't want to be in opposition to God. Stop being opposition to God. I know you're a brave person. I know you're a bad hombre. But you don't want to mock God. You've been deliberately sinning. You've been willingly sinning. You've come to the complete knowledge of the truth. And now you're willingly separating yourself and from the church and from God, and you're seeking your own desire, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the world, the lust of your eyes. And you've come to a point, amen, that all you do is reveal your own opinions. And now it's become from your innerness, out of the abundance of your heart. Now you're ashamed and full of reproach. But come back. Go back to your church. Go back to God. Your brothers and your sisters will be excited to see you. I promise you. Coronavirus, no coronavirus. We're going to hug you. We're going to bring you back into the family. I promise you. Because there's nothing else but judgment. Stop deliberately sinning. Stop willingly sinning. Any person who has violated and rejected and set at naught the law of Moses is put to death without pity or mercy. On the evidence or two or three witnesses. That's why he is the Father. He is the Son. He is the Holy Spirit. And Jesus didn't come to abolish the law, but he fulfilled the law. That means he is the way. The manna. Let me show you something. Raul and Lisa Rodriguez gave me this beautiful Ark of the Covenant. And in the Ark of the Covenant, on top of the mercy seat, there are three things that I want to show you. Jesus. This is the manna. He is the way. Jesus. The law. He is the truth. Jesus. The rod. The rod of Aaron. He is the life. He is the way. He is the truth. He is the life. No one comes to the Father except through Christ Jesus. 102.3 Radio Vida, La Estación Diferente. You're listening to the number one show on the midday, 91.9. Radio Compañerismo, Rio Grande Valley. We thank you so much for tuning in. Hey, listen, I'm going to continue working on our show. I'm going to continue bringing you good word. If that is you, man, come home. Come home. God is waiting for you with open arms. As soon as you start drawing to him, the Father will start running towards you. The Bible says that when you draw closer to God, he will draw near you. He wants to draw near you. Are you willing? Are you willing to do a 180 and repent right now? And if you do, let's pray. Father, we thank you this evening, this afternoon. Father, we ask you in the mighty name of Jesus for those that heard this message right now. Father, that they're about to repent. They are repenting right now. They are turning from their evil way. They are being converted as we speak, my God. Father, as they repent and they are converting in the name of Jesus, Father, their sins are being blotted out. And Father, because you are holy, they are holy. And Father, in the name of Jesus, the Bible says that in your presence comes a refreshment. A refreshment that no swimming pool in summer, no lake in the summer can refresh you like the presence of God. You're listening to the number one show at the 12 o'clock here, the Life Fire Radio Show. Suele.
You are now listening to the Live Fire Radio Show with Pastor Bethel on 91.9 FM Fellowship Radio, number one show in the Rio Grande Valley. 102.3 FM Life Radio, number one show in Fort Smith, Arkansas, and number one Facebook Live show at noon. Stay tuned for God's Word by Pastor Beto. Súbele!
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.